Hello viewers, thanks for your support. In our channel, we are continuously discussing about concept behind fire production engineering. Today also, we are going to see one interesting topic. Let's see, let's move. Actually, one of our channel subscriber, Mr. Dhananjay Padai, requested the video regarding water speed system for cable gallery. So regarding the calculation part, he is asking. So this is the topic today. We are going to see this. So prior to start this topic, a small introduction for water speed system. Actually, water speed system is a main extension of water-based fire production. Nowadays, water speed systems are used mainly for substation oil field transformers, horizontal and vertical fuel storage tanks, cooling towers, etc., etc. So these are the main objectives of water speed system. Extinguishment of fire, control of burning, exposure protection, prevention of fire. So through water speed system, we can do these all mechanisms. So this is a typical arrangement of water speed system. So it seems like almost all sprinkler system. So instead of sprinklers, the nozzle will be there. So instead of alarm check wall, the deluge wall will be there along with these direction lines. So appropriate standard is NFA 15. That's it. Introduction is over. We can move to our AutoCAD drawing for the calculation part. This is the AutoCAD plan view for substation cable basement along with the cable trays. The substance which are contains green color, the tall cable trays. You can see here the full continuation. So this is a section view of that plan view. So cable trays contained with the insulated cable will look like this. So there are many types are there along with floor, overhanging types, single level, dual level. I have seen three level, four level also. In substations. So actually, why fire production request required for this cable trays or cable galleries? Particularly, why water space system required for this these areas? So actually, in substation cables help to passes the high electrical energy, but at the same time, that cables are made with insulated cable that is made with group A or group B plastics that is actually highly combustible. So we can assume the scenario. So high electrical energy, high combustible product. So if short circuit happens or some fire happens, so it results worst effects. There are many possibilities are there. It may create the big fire. So only we NFA 15 insists to go with water space system for these kind of areas. So this is actually the high hazard areas. So this is a calculation part, six number of steps I have made. So we can use the six steps for any kind of occupancies. So step number one, determine the area accurate. So which area we are going to protect, that we need to determine, find. So here in our case, we are going to protect a cable tray. So these are cable trays, this green color lines. We are going to find the area. So how do we can find? So length of the cable tray from here to here, I made, for example, it is 16 meter actually from here to here. And the width of the cable tray is 0.6 meter. So we can multiply this both, we can get the square meter value. So through this manner, we have to calculate this total area of cable tray. So this one I already made it. So the total area of cable tray is 293.7 square meter. So step number one is over. Step number two, determine the design density. Actually, as I told you earlier, NFA 15 is appropriate standard. NFA 15 demands at least 6.1 LPM per square meter for cable tray or cable running areas for section 7.2.2 2.1. So this one, in our calculation, I taken this value 6.1 LPM per square meter. So step number two is over. Step number three, determine the water demand based on the area density method. Actually, this both values we have. So area we already find from that our plan view. So design density we already taken from NFA. So these are two values. So if we are multiplying this value, means we can get this answer. So this is the answer for water demand based on the area density method. So 1787 is LPM is the minimum water requirement of particular cable tray area. So step number three is over. Step number four, determine the number of nozzles. Actually, this is a important step. Little bit it will confusing little bit. So in order to array the proper number of nozzles, we need to keep some considerations in our mind. So consideration number one, what NFA says about the nozzle spacing. Actually, this is a description provided NFA regarding nozzle spacing. So nozzle, the design shall ensure the nozzle spray patterns meet or overlap. Nozzle spacing vertically or horizontally shall not exceed 3 meters. Let me show the AutoCAD form. So this is a nozzle. This is a coverage of nozzle. Water discharge coverage means water discharge. Assume this is a water discharge pattern. Okay, this is a section view. This is actually the plan view I made. So what NFA says, these values, distance between this nozzle should not exceed 3 meter. So here it is actually 4.2 meter. This is actually wrong. We should keep our nozzle like this. So 2.8, we should the nozzle to nozzle should distance should not exceed 3 meter, and also the coverage, this is the coverage of nozzle, the coverage should meet or overlap. Okay, so this is a fact, this is a important consideration provided by NFA. So consideration one is over. Consideration number two, nozzle water discharge angle and pattern. Actually, this consideration number two and three related to nozzle characteristics. This nozzle characteristics we can get from the manufacturer catalog. So for example, here I attached the catalog. So this nozzle catalog contains many informations regarding nozzle characteristics like K factor, GA drawings, patterns, everything. So whatever the informations we need, we can get from here. Also, prior to select the nozzle, prior to array the number of nozzles. So we need to read completely this one. Then only we can get the better design. So back to consideration number two, nozzle water discharge angle and pattern. In the catalog itself, we can see there are many type of water discharge angle and patterns are available. So based on our requirement, we can take this angles. So in our case, for example, 90 degree, 110 degree, 90 degree, 95 degree, many patterns, many angles are available. So based on our requirement, we can take, for our case, we I taken for 140 degree. So consideration number three, axial and radial distance. So what is axial distance? What is radial distance? Axial distance is distance between the nozzle spray point to protected surface. So what is the area we are going to protect from that particular substance to nozzle spray point? So what is the distance between this both? So that is actually the axial distance. So here you can see this is a protected surface. This is a nozzle. This particular part is nozzle spray point. From here to here, I taken my axial distance is 445. Okay. So what is the radial distance? Radial distance is nothing. This is actually the coverage of nozzle. So this is the coverage of nozzle. So here I, my radial distance is for each side 740 mm, and in additions this axial distance will impact the radial distance. You can see here for 445 axial distance it will provide 740 radial distance, it will come. So if I put 170 mm as a axial distance, I can get only 475 mm for this radial distance. So axial distance is directly proportional, radial distance is directly proportional to axial distance. So if axial distance increases, so the radial distance also will increase. But so how we can select this axial distance? So it is purely based on the site conditions. Some places you can put your nozzles like this. You have a space, you can put your nozzles like this. So if some cases you cannot put, you can put your nozzle this kind for this one, for less space only. So that kind of situations you don't have any options. You will get very less number of radial distance. Radial distance means nozzle coverage. So that kind of time we don't have any option. We need to add additional nozzles in order to avoid the dry areas. You can see here the nozzle pattern will complete finish here. Hereafter there is no coverage. So we cannot put like this. We need to put additional nozzles in order to adjust, in order to wet here. Okay. So this is what I'm telling. These factors, if I'm putting two nozzles, means the nozzle quantity has been increased. So this is what I'm telling. These factor create a major impact on the nozzle quantities. So prior to array the number of nozzles, we need to made a proper calculation of with these considerations. So consideration number three is over axial and radial distances. So in our case, I made the design already. So these are the cable tray, these are the nozzle coverages. Based on the nozzle coverages and everything, I made with nozzle to nozzle distance 2.6 meter. So based on the nozzle coverage I made with, so all the cable tray areas are covered and also overlap. So I got the nozzle quantity actually 45. My nozzle quantity is 45. Okay. Step number four is over. And step number five. So whatever the water demand we determined before, how we can discharge on the particular arcoid area, particular surface through the nozzles. So for water discharge character, K factor is very important. So we have the formula for K factor to array the K factor. So K is equal to Q divided by root P. So here pressure is 1.54 bar. This value actually it mentioned from NFA 15. NFA 15 insists to go with the nozzle pressure should be minimum 1.4 bar. So we have the value here, and Q is 39.1. So how I can array this Q value? For this is actually a flow for one nozzle. The flow of one nozzle at least provide this water discharge. So from this value, whatever the value I array from design area method, so 1787 divided by 45 number of nozzles, I can get this value. Okay, so this is a water discharge rate of minimum water discharge rate of one nozzle. So if you are applying this formula, means we can get the answer. So I got the answer 33. So my K factor is 33. So I checked the nozzle manufacturer catalog. Here this is a K factor list. So 31 is available, 36 available, but I need 33, but there is no 33. So due to the absence of that particular K factor, I select the higher end. So my K factor is 36. So my K factor I put here 36. So I find the K factor also. Step number 5 is over. Then step number 6. Determine the water demand based on the nozzle K factor and nozzle quantity. So we have the both. Nozzle K factor we have, nozzle quantity we have. And also in order to find the flow, we have the formula. This is reverse of this K factor formula. Q is equal to K into root P. So P we know already, root 1.4 bar. K we know already, that is 36. So we are going to find the exact water demand of nozzle with this particular K factor. So we can put 36 into root 1.4 bar. So I got the answer for 42.5 LPM. For this particular 36 K factor, the water discharge will be 42.5 LPM. So we can calculate the 45 number of nozzle means the value will come 1916. So the value is little bit higher than this. So our calculation is, our manual calculation is satisfied. So our calculation part is, the step number 6 is over, and also the calculation part is over. For additional some informations, actually this the calculation steps will be applicable for all kind of water space systems, but based on the cable tray, based on the substation arrangements, so the calculations result will vary. For example, here I consider for one level of nozzles, I did not consider for two level of nozzles. If I am considering two level of nozzles, means I need to put dual level of nozzle. So the nozzle quantity will increase. Nozzle quantity will increase means K factor will change, water demand will change, everything will change. So that's why I'm telling, based on some factors, based on the location, based on the hazard. So some of the calculation will vary a little bit. So that's all. So if you have any clarifications, please put on comment section. I hope everyone understand this video. Thank you very much. And thank you very much, Mr. Dhanajay, asking for this video. Thanks.